LPG Collective, what's happening? Let's see what's going on with you on this lovely Saturday. Take what resonates, leave the rest. Take it how it resonates you and your situation, okay? One-on-ones, personal readings, all that good stuff is in the description box on the website, y'all. And I always appreciate y'all for watching. Okay, so this is what we have so far. The golden mirror. Okay, these are random words. Take the words how they resonate. We have narcissist, love bombing, self-absorbed, and one-sided. Alrighty then. We have blowing kiss, and this is unconditional love, giving and receiving, fairness and love, affection return. So I've been seeing a lot about balance and giving and receiving. And then we have addiction, codependent, obsession and restraint, possession and control, emotional block. All right, let's get one more spirit for the collective. Okay, and we have coffin, and this one is new beginnings, liberation, reborn in transition, tragic endings. All right, we have wedding rings here on the bottom. So this one is about union and marriage, soul connection, everlasting love and devotion. I saw that one earlier. So overall energy is an interesting one. I feel like you could be dealing with someone that is kind of one-sided, that was breadcrumbing you. Take this how it resonates, okay, because it could be you, the person that is watching that is, you know, the breadcrumber and et cetera, et cetera. But I feel like there is some unconditional love here. Someone may equate love to obsession or codependency as well. Someone may not have a very clear understanding of what love is necessarily. So we'll dive deeper and see. But with the coffin here, I love how there is going to be some type of new beginning. So there could be a new beginning for you on your own, with a new person, with this person. We'll see. I'm loving it so far. Okay, well, we have the Wheel of Fortune. Love it. And we have the Four of Wands. I'm also seeing, interesting, because the cards kind of flipped over like this. I'm seeing the Four of Cups and the Four of Pentacles under there, and then the King of Cups under there. So four, 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 something stable, something solid. Fours are very, very solid. Now, fours can be kind of boring as well, but fours are very grounded and solid numbers. So someone may very well see you as their soulmate. The Wheel of Fortune is also a soulmate card. So you have literally two soulmate cards. The Four of Cups can sometimes be about contentment, can be someone being comfortable. It really just depends on the surrounding energies. If you're familiar with the Thoth Tarot, Thoth deck, this card is called luxury, and it's called that because you are, whoever is in this picture is comfortable. The imagery is different. Y'all can easily Google Thoth, T-H-O-T-H, and check out the deck. But I've said before how that this card is kind of a different meaning than this one. But yeah, I feel like there is someone here that's very comfortable with you, very at home with you. With the Wheel of Fortune here under this love bombing energy, I feel like someone is changing that. I love that. I feel like if this person was one-sided, I feel like it is changing to this more give and take energy. Holy shit. Have that lined up. Wow. Okay. Well, all right, let's see what else comes out. Page of Wands, could be someone younger than you, could be a fire sign that you're dealing with. Someone may not be the most mature with the page coming up here under codependent obsession. There is definitely a codependency here, but I feel like some of you may take a more parental role with this person. Oh yeah, take that how it resonates. That's not gonna resonate with all of you guys, But if you haven't heard from this person, you will, because they can't stay away from you. It's just like I said, you have this feeling of home to this person. It's like you two belong together. Some of you may be seeing 444 as well, but it's something very solid and stable. And this person does love you unconditionally, despite, you know, them being full of shit sometimes. But I feel like this person does love you unconditionally. You know, even through all of your spells and all of your nonsense, I feel like this person will still be there for you, even, you know, through their BS. Okay, there's that Eight of Cups. Mm-hmm. And then I'm also seeing the Ten of Pentacles, the Knight of Swords, and the Three of Cups here on the bottom. So I feel like there is a need to detach. Now, with the Eight of Cups here, though, I feel like there could be some type of new beginning. Because what the Eight of Cups is doing is on the search for happiness. Now, this could be you, or this could be someone in your energy, like on a quest for happiness. See, that cup there is missing. And I feel like these are the cups that are being left behind. So it's like the figure in this card is taking what they can. It's like that song by Erykah Badu. When she says pack light, bag lady, you gonna hurt your bag, you gonna hurt your back carrying all those bags. So somebody needs to leave their baggage in the past. Like I said, this could be you, or this could be someone in your energy. Someone needs to leave something in the past and have something new. It could be too, this person may compare you to stuff going on from their past, or compare you to a past person. Their past person could have had this love bombing, one-sided narcissist energy, and then when they came to you, they kind of treated you like you were going to act like that past person. And this could be vice versa. You kind of treated them like, you know, a person from your past. But I also feel like if you did leave somebody alone, you know, don't bring any of your trauma, your past trauma, to your new connection. Make sure you're fully healed from that before you move on, because if you don't, then you're going to have a scenario all over again. What did you see in this King of Swords? The King of Swords, yeah. The Sun, I'm loving this. The Seven of Swords here on the bottom. Oh, so what I'm getting with this, especially seeing the Seven of Swords on the bottom, someone may have felt like they didn't deserve happiness, or they didn't deserve you, or vice versa. Take it how it resonates with you. I'm seeing a more, this is so similar to the reading that I just did. Someone is wanting to be better. You made somebody want to be better, collective. With this golden mirror here, and y'all know I like to look at the Wheel of Fortune as the wheel turning, okay? The top is usually where it started, and the bottom is usually where the wheel is going. Or if it's this way, it's vice versa, okay? But I don't have a card on this side. Maybe I should pull one for this side. But I feel like the narcissist, one-sided breadcrumbing, is now turning into someone that wants to be better, wants to have more integrity, wants to live more in their values, wants to be more traditional, conservative. The King of Swords, despite how nonchalant the King of Swords can be, the King of Swords is always wanting to do the right thing. Like I've said before, the swords are about like they're about like law and government and doing the right thing. So I feel like that's what's going on here, collective. Someone wanting to be better, or you encourage someone to be better. And whatever they went through in the past, yeah, thank you, spirits, Nine of Swords. Whatever they went through in the past has nothing to do with you. Whatever you went through in the past has nothing to do with whatever connection you have right now, collective. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Five of Pentacles. Now, the Five of Pentacles, especially with this surrounding energy, is someone kind of toughing it out through thick and thin. The Five of Pentacles gives a codependency vibe sometimes, okay? It's just sticking it out no matter what. Eight of Pentacles, yeah, someone really, really, really wants to work this out with you. So take it how it resonates. If this is someone you haven't talked to in a while, or if this is someone that you have recently had a fight with, you probably fought with them about, you know, saying that they're selfish and they only think about themselves or whatever. I feel like they don't want to be that way. Someone wants to be happy. That's what they want. They want happiness. And they're learning how to give equally give and take. Because they may have been someone that... Sometimes when we're on a healing journey, we can go through extremes. So we'll get into a connection and we overgive and we overgive and we overgive. And then we feel taken advantage of, right? So then we get in the connection after that. And then we become kind of one-sided because we're like, well, I'm not going to give until they do. I'm not going to do this, that until they do. But you're not really being yourself. You're holding back, and then you're ultimately making yourself miserable because that person can kind of see what's going on, and then that person eventually is going to lose interest and move on, okay? Because people can see your trauma, even if it's not on a conscious level. People can see your trauma energetically in many cases, okay? So if this wasn't you, this could have been someone you were dealing with that gave and gave and gave in their last connection, and then... when it came to you, they didn't want to give because they didn't want to end up in an overgiving situation again like they had before. Like I said, comparing you to somebody from their past. Love it. I'm also seeing the Ace of Wands, the Six of Wands, the Empress, and the Eight of Swords. Also the Ten of Swords here on the bottom. So I feel like I said, someone wanting to be more balanced, wanting to cooperate with you more, wanting to compromise with you more. Because like I said, you are dealing with someone that may be used to being taken advantage of. And like I said, always take the roles how they resonate with you because it could be you. So when you have somebody like that, every little thing you do, I feel like they may have thought that you were trying to take advantage or you were trying to get over. But that's what happens when you're dealing with someone that operates from trauma. They don't really think things through. And sometimes people do these trauma responses and they don't even realize that's what they're doing. Actually, most people don't realize that they're operating from trauma. Four of Swords, yep. The King of Swords again, you guys. I feel like you've changed someone's energy. You've changed someone's energy. And again, this one-sided stuff I feel like that this person was doing was a defense mechanism. To try to keep from being taken advantage of. Queen of Pentacles. Mm-hmm. What I tell you, I'm seeing the Three of Swords, the Lovers, and the Seven of Pentacles. Now, for some of you, this person, there could be a concern that you are moving on or you have moved on, especially if it's taking this person for a long time. Also, the Three of Swords can be about, if you're not talking to this person, someone breaking the silence between you two. Someone coming forward, someone like kind of moving, putting things in motion. After a break, because what I'm seeing here in the spread, take it how it resonates, is you two could be on a break. Yeah, Four of Cups here. Two of Pentacles. There could be a money problem too. Two of Swords here on the bottom, but the Two of Pentacles also has this infinity symbol here. So it's like no matter where you, what happens between you two, it's like they always make their way back. The Two of Pentacles kind of gives me a vibe of the Five as well. It's like ups and downs. Somebody wanting to be there for you and wanting you around
despite the ups and downs, despite the through the good and the bad, through the thick and the thin, through the rich and the poor, this is what this person wants, to be there for you no matter what. And they want you there with them no matter what. And I feel like they always kind of, you know, kind of make their way back. Ace of Cups here on the bottom. Yeah, always kind of make their way back. But I do see that there is like an unconditional thing going on here. Like this person, I feel like they may not say it, they may not show it, but it's like no matter what, this person is always going to be there. Like they'll always be around. That's the vibe I get. It may not seem like it, but really, really, spirit. Look what flips over. The Six of Pentacles. I told you, collected. Ace of Pentacles. Love it. And then we have the Magician here as well. Yeah. Equal give and take. Balance. This person wanted to reciprocate your energy, but I feel like, and if this isn't a past person, you're going to get someone that's going to be willing to reciprocate to you. I feel like whatever you've given out, the love you've given out is going to be returned to you tenfold. Okay. Whether it's from a person or this particular person on your mind or someone else. All right, because I'm kind of getting the vibe there could be someone else entering or already here. All right, so let's get a couple handwritten's collective, and then we gonna wrap this on up. Love it, love to see it. I feel like this person sees you as like marriage material, spouse material. What About Us by Eric Billinger. Yeah. I feel like no matter how detached this person is, I feel like this person they do love you unconditionally, collective. Even through their shenanigans, you know. They may have a hard time showing it.
Which is probably something they've never
experienced before. So what fell out? What, y'all, look what's on the bottom. I can't fucking make this up. Look what's on the bottom. My love for you will never fade. I told you. Could be an air sign. This one popped out onto the floor face up. So it could be a Gemini, Libra, or an Aquarius. And like I said, we kept seeing that King of Swords. I know my pride and ego can be too much at times. I told you. What did I tell you, y'all? Mm-hmm. It's coming. Be open to receive. I told you something was coming. All right. New person, old person, Everybody Knows by John Legend. This song is literally talking about someone moving on. So they may ask you that if you haven't talked to them. I hope it's not too late for us. Yeah, if you haven't talked to them in a while, I feel like they may ask you that. I'm mad at myself for how I treated you. I told you. Selfish, self-absorbed, breadcrumbing. I'm about to call/text you. I told you, hurting you only hurt myself. I told you, collective, nobody feels as good as you do because you don't love anyone else unconditionally. That's why I really need you in my life. Yes. Wine and dying, I told you, somebody's gonna pull out all the stops for you, collective. All right, LPG Collective, hit that like, hit that subscribe if you haven't yet. Thank you guys so much for watching. Peace out.